Good morning, I'm Eric Scott. This is New Jersey's First News for Friday, September 15th. It is going to be a bit breezy and a little cooler today than it was yesterday as Hurricane Lee passes by. But our chief meteorologist Dan Zero says we will not see rain from this storm, and we should be relatively rain-free through the weekend. Sunday's rain is not from this storm. Full forecast details are available on air online at nj1015.com and on our free mobile app. It is now New England that is staring down Hurricane Lee. Here is the latest track from the National Weather Service. Maine Governor Janet Mills has declared a state of emergency. The state is also under its first hurricane watch in 15 years. The waterlogged region is getting ready for wind gusts up to 80 miles an hour, along with more rain. It is also likely to be a very rough weekend off the New Jersey coastline. Already the surf is churning as Hurricane Lee heads north, creating dangerous swimming conditions like rip currents. And swimmers who disobey lifeguards this weekend or swim after hours in the rough water off Seaside Heights could be facing a ticket. The fines would be as high as $1,200. We have expanded coverage, everything you need to know about Lee and its impacts, on air, online at nj1015.com and on our free mobile app. As state health officials are warning about a resurgence in COVID infections driven by a new variant, a South Jersey hospital has returned to a mask mandate. All employees are required to mask up again, and they are asking patients and visitors to do the same. More New Jersey hospitals are considering it. Neither Governor Murphy nor his health commissioner have said if they're considering a renewed blanket mask mandate in all healthcare settings in New Jersey. Employees of an LGBT nonprofit are being accused of sneaking an agenda into non-related classes. The group has been caught on video admitting they're injecting gender and sex lessons into unrelated courses at some Princeton schools in order to prevent parents from opting students out. The conservative investigative group Project Veritas released the video showing employees from the group High Tops explaining that to prevent parents from opting out of sex education lessons that include gender-affirming language and practices, they add the material into a three-day course called Pathways to Racial Literacy. Parents cannot opt out of courses on race and ethnicity. Princeton Public Schools Superintendent Carol Kelly says they are investigating. It is a story that is difficult to hear, but one the victim of a sexual assault says you need to. She is adding her voice to the plea for tips to catch her attacker. The victim was involved in a daytime sex assault in a Monmouth County park she thought was safe nearly 2 years ago. She tells us she understands people may be hesitant to come forward with information, but hopes they'll do so anyway. Out of respect for her privacy, New Jersey 101.5 has agreed not to disclose the woman's name. This is a photo of the suspect. Any possible tips on the November 2021 assault can be shared with Marlboro Police and the Monmouth County Prosecutor's Office. Dulce Alves was 5 when she vanished from a Bridgeton park. She'd be 9 now, and kids can change an awful lot in just 4 years. A new age progression photo has been released by investigators, hoping it'll help somebody identify her and bring her home. The Cumberland County prosecutor says this is very much an active case. Investigators recently traveling out of state to follow up on new tips about the case. How would you rate your child's school, and do you believe it's safe? That's the subject of a new Eagleton survey we're telling you about this morning. 3/4 of New Jerseyans feel public schools in their community are very or somewhat safe. But when asked about the biggest safety issue facing our schools, the top response was guns or school shootings. New Jersey did add thousands of jobs last month, but the unemployment rate still went up. The Department of Labor releasing preliminary estimates for August job numbers on Thursday. The private sector gained about 6,700 jobs last month, but the estimated unemployment rate is now 3.9%. The State Labor Department says it's due to more residents joining the labor force and fewer residents being employed. An alert motorist was able to save a bald eagle in New Jersey. This happened in Burlington County. The eagle was on the ground and struggling in the southbound lanes of Route 206. The driver scooped the eagle up and got it out of the road, then called 911. Animal control came to take the raptor to a rehab facility in Lambertville. The eagle appears to have had a broken wing. Have something to say about our top stories? Leave your comments right here. Please like and share this video. And remember, we're always taking your calls, talking Jersey on air on New Jersey 101.5. I'm Eric Scott. That's New Jersey's First News for this Friday, September 15th. It's made possible by the Bet Parks Casino and Sportsbook app. Have a safe and a happy weekend.